Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm going to talk about what is mechanosensing unit. So maybe some of them attending yesterday's seminar, you are repeated about this topic. So anyhow, for your enhancing understanding, yeah, I'm going to talk about this. But most of you heard first about this mechanosensing unit. So for understanding how the cell sense the mechanical property, for example, stiffness, aka rigidity. So what kind of things in your mind, how the cell can touch and feel or sense the stiffness, rigidity, or some mechanical property of the extracellular matrix? Maybe you guys can think about integrin, they can attach, and then maybe actin, they can pull and push the integrin, and then they can sense the stiffness. But this is some kind of overall concept. And then in detail, how they sense. So for example, this is some integrin, and this is actin. So somehow the integrin and actin, they are connected to each other through focal adhesion protein complex, including vinculin, paxillin, or any kind of protein, maybe over 10 or 20 protein types. But they just pull and push individually, or they have certain unit to sense the stiffness. So for understanding or for evaluating this kind of concept, people want to know how the cell attach the substrate and then when they start to sense. So this is some example of the how cell attach on substrate using the fibroblast. So fibroblast spreading occur in several stages. First, initial attachment, called P0, rapid increase in contact area, P1, slower contractile spreading, P2, during the protrusion retraction cycle were observed. This is some description about the P2. Okay, so this image is from this a live cell image. So over time, from 0 to 1,200 seconds, they cut this in the middle diameter. And then over time, let's say this is depicted in here, 0. And then at 300 seconds, maybe this cell is enlarged, and then also cut in the middle, and then depicted in here. And then like this, every time you can capture the images using your movie, and then you cut at the center, and then put it here. So, and you can see this kind of, over time, this kind of diameter is increasing of cell. So this is some initial cell attachment, not much of change of the cell diameter. Like how long? Around 100 seconds. Okay, this is second, so which means 2 minutes. About 2 minutes, they attach. And then they start to spread, rapid increase. You can see this kind of incline. Yeah, the slope is quite high, higher than this initial. And then suddenly, this slope is decreasing, but anyhow they are enlarged, the diameter, right? So this is called P1, rapid increase, and this is P2, slow contractile spreading. So in here you can see in detail how they show some contractile spreading, but in detail you can observe, I will show you later. Anyhow, they start to spread, but with less slope. So you can imagine after 2 minutes later, up to 5 minutes, there the cell are showing rapid increase of their diameter, and then suddenly they adjust and then decline the slope. So for example, if you want to evaluate your material, like let's say fibronectin, collagen, or any kind of protein, and then which can be deposited on the tissue culture plate, and then you can use these optical images, how they behave. So with or without coating, how fast the cell sends. So you can determine the time of P1 and P0. So if your coating material like peptide or protein, they can give fast P1 phase, and then somehow it can be good, right? But when you use some metal, polymer, or ceramic, any kind of non-transparent, which means it's not observed by optical images, but and then it's not easy to see this kind of increase of diameter directly from the microscope, light microscope. In that case, what can be used? So you can dye the cell, especially cell membrane. So they are commercially available, and in iTrain also we have this kind of dye that can stain the lipid, and then from pre-staining the lipid of the cell membrane, you can observe this kind of phenomenon on your material, like titanium, metal, or polymer. So this is a very basic phenomenon, but very simple, but you can understand how your material can enhance the cell initial spreading or adjustment. Like, let's say you are fabricating your germa, and then like amar, you decorate with cerium, and then you want to evaluate how the cell sends the cerium deposit germa. And then you can compare germa itself, how fast they attach, and then compared to germa cellia. So let's say germa cellia, they are shortened about this P1, and somehow it's good. And then you can evaluate how the slope of P1 and P2 between the bare germa and then germa cellia. And then depending on the stiffness, you are making different stiffness of PDMS, like 2 kilopascal, 10, 100 kilopascal, how fast, and then how homogeneously cell sense the substrate, and then this P1 and P2 slope, when and how long they are observed. So within just 1 hour, you can finish your project, right? Of course, before doing the experiment, you have to find other researcher already done this or not. Maybe about the stiffness, maybe some of them already did. Well, I'm not sure. Maybe nobody did, and then you can try whether you can observe different P1 and P2 slope or time depending on these things. So this kind of over time cutting and then attaching in this kind of manner, you can get this kind of images by yourself, like manually, maybe 1 second you cut and put it here. But maybe you can use MATLAB or ImageJ to observe, to get this kind of images. Actually, I don't have experience to do this. Only I observe in the literature, but I'm pretty sure you guys can do. So I also try to find how I can do this, but some software in the microscope, they give this kind of shifting images too, from this movie to this kind of 2D images. But in our hand, maybe we have to find our way. So this is some movie, how cell grow on the substrate. Like this, using your developed material, you can observe how cell spread. Okay. So also we have what is that? Live cell image analysis tool, Julie Stage, in our iTrain. So Julie Stage can visualize the cell on different well. So and then in each well you can adjust the focus. So you can detect this kind of cell spreading images very easily using Julie Stage. And then people want to know, okay, so we can understand the cell spread. And then when they see this, they need push and pull force the cell to sense the substrate. But using this flat TCP or flat PDMS, scientists cannot determine, measure the how much cell need the force to push and pull to fill the substrate. And then next step is, okay, and then we are going to make this kind of pillar. Pillar means this kind of dot, but with proper diameter. And then pillar, distance is twice of this diameter. And then they want to know how we can obtain similar cell attachment pattern using PDMS pillar to compare to flat surface. For what? To analyze cell contraction unit. So using the flat surface, they cannot measure. But when they use this pillar, when cell push and pull using their own stress, this pillar can be deflected. They can be changed. Even though the change of the position is a little bit very low value than you expect, but anyhow, theoretically, they can be bended. And then when you merge your initial without cell versus cell with a pillar, and then you can determine how much this pillar is bended. So as you can imagine, smaller diameter can show more bending ability. But large diameter, they somehow resist. But from the mechanical formula, we can already know how much of the force can be needed to bend this kind of pillar. So you can make 0.5, 1, 2, 4, 10 micrometer pillar, as many as you want. And then the final goal is, what can be the best pillar diameter to have similar pattern with the flat PDMS? So we want to know how the cell sense the flat. Flat means just normal. We can say, just in here, in this context, we just say this can be normal. But in our body, we cannot say flat surface is normal. But anyhow, flat versus what is the similar with the flat. So they are making 0.512 micrometer. So they first check the focal adhesion protein, which is paxillin here. And then PMLC is some upstream of the paxillin focal adhesion complex. So, but is it one of the focal adhesion protein phenomenon? In case of 2 micrometer, this is center, but most of the paxillin or PMLC are observed where? Not the center, edge, right? And they are merged. But in case of 0.5 micrometer, density is very little, but they are in the center, not on the edge. Oh, it's very interesting. Depending on the pillar diameter, when the cell attached on this pillar, somehow 0.5 in the center, 2 micrometer on the edge, and then they are merged. So this was quantified. So from the center of the pillar to the edge, this 2 micrometer, most of the intensity were observed on the edge, this center to the edge. But in case of this small diameter, 0.5 micrometer, most of them, especially this Paxlin focal adhesion complex, was observed on the center. So we can say, oh, this is dramatically different. Okay? And then they observed the rear cell pattern on the substrate. So flat PDMS, 0.5 and 2 micromole, 2 micrometer pillar. Which one is more similar to flat PDMS? 0.5, right? So, oh, previously, this paper, most of people used 1 to 4 micrometer pillar to understand how the cell sense the surface. But for the increasing of the technology to make this kind of 0.5 micrometer pillar, because they have to use some lithography or any kind of engineering technique to make this kind of pillar structure. So they make some rationale why the scientists have to use 0.5 micrometer to understand the cell on the flat PDMS. And then now they are using 0.5 micrometer. Now this is some video of the flat and 0.5 micrometer pillar PDMS. This dot 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 is kind of pillar. So they say somehow they behave similarly. And then they are using fibroblast. So, okay, using this TEMA, you can change the cell type like raw cell, THPN cell, HUVEC cell, MSC, muscle cell. So when nobody done about this kind of, okay, this is from fibroblast, but what happened when I culture the CT12, raw cell, THPN cell, they behave differently on flat or 0.5 micrometer or not? After checking the other literature, you can try. Yeah. This is some simple, and then you can report. Maybe, and then you can make some rationale why maybe the different cell can sense differently using different focal adhesion complex formation. And then, especially in case of immune cell, they have very small body than compared to other fibroblasts. Fibroblasts and mesenchymal cell, they are prone to spread. But low cell or immune cell, their behavior is not originally for spreading. They just attach or want to engulf some other toxin or other bacteria. So somehow they have different behavior. And then in case of keratinocyte, skin cell, not a fibroblast, epithelial cell, also they can behave differently. So when you can find some your rationale to behave differently, and then you can do this one. So, and then from this finding for confirming 0.5 and 1 and 2 micrometer are different, have different behave from the cell, they check how the pillar are deflected, bended. So in case of 0.5, they found this is a vector. So you cannot see in detail how this pillar bended, but very concisely, when you merge the original this kind of pillar and then on the cell, when you put together, you can see a little change. So this kind of change can be measured using ImageJ or MATLAB. So also in iTrend, we Seongmin and did this kind of vector change depending on cell attachment or without cell using the ImageJ program. So anyhow, A and B, this A is 1 micrometer, B is 0.5 micrometer. And then especially A, this is some red, yellow line is cell boundary. And then most of the pillar is bended into the center area. But in case of B, using 0.5 micrometer pillar, they are sometime close each other as a unit. So this come and go, pull and push, pull and push. So this is some how the cell sends the pillar. In case of 1 or 2 micrometer, R, the value when one is 1 is, they are parallel. Parallelly, yeah, bended. But in case of 0 means the different direction as a unit. So you can see more this kind of pull and push vector can be observed on 0.5 micrometer pillar, but not 1 and 2 micrometer pillar. Okay, so this direction is different between 0.5 and 1 and 2 micrometer. And then how much they are deflected. So this is some deflection as a nanometer. But 500 nanometer and 1,000 nanometer, which means 0.5 micrometer and 1 micrometer. And then maybe you can see the difference easily, right? And then this is from 0.5 micrometer pillar, and then blue is low stiffness, green, intermediate, red, high stiffness. As you can see, depending on the stiffness, the bended real value, absolute value is different. High stiffness, low bend. This is true. Because they need this high stiffness, they need more, even though the cell makes some same force, but real absolute value bended is lower in here. But in case of 1 and 0.5, especially 0.5, the bended amount is not that much different among the stiffness, right? And then when you look at this F max, which is average maximum shear stress calculated from this bended diameter and then this kind of value of the stiffness of the pillar, and then you can determine depending on how the cell make the maximum force per area, and then this K value is stiffness value. So depending on the stiffness change, the maximum force induced by cell are linearly plotted only on 0.5 micrometer. So which means 1 and 2 micrometer pillar, cell sense behave differently, but this linear slope is much lower than 0.5. So there's why we can, in 0.5, 1, and 2, you can see this kind of slope on the right upper. But the slope, incline slope is higher in 0.5 micrometer, which means they sense more sensitively, cell can more sensitively feel and sense the stiffness of substrate on the 0.5 micrometer. So this is another rationale why the scientists and you guys have to use 0.5 micrometer pillar. Maybe, and then they want to test whether this can local displacement will link to rigidity sensing, especially on 0.5 micrometer pillar, and then they find receptor-like protein tyrosine phosphatase, which is called RPTP-alpha, as one of the sensing biochemical signaling. So this is without knockout this RPTP-alpha for sensing the stiffness. So this is some low stiffness substrate pillar, high stiffness substrate pillar, and then red one, plus plus means normal, and minus means we knock down. So in normal, okay, this the cell can sense and they give some bending amount of the pillar on 0.5 micrometer. But this is a 50 and maybe 50 or 45, and then they convert this change of the diameter, change of the bended absolute value with the consideration of the this stiffness, and then you can determine how the cell make the force. So anyhow, with this RPTP alpha, you can observe the cell sense and make the force to bend the pillar. But when they knock down this RPTP alpha, the bended amount is almost similar to noise. Okay. And then this is some count of the how much they bend it. This is the normal. And then after they half knock down, and then they produce, express RPTP alpha again, and then this, they are gone, and then they are recovered. So this is some basic way how to prove the law of the RPTF alpha, or law of your interest of the protein. So we can say that they cannot say in detail how this Paxlin focal adhesion complex link to RPTF alpha, but previously many people mentioned that this RPTF alpha protein tyrosine phosphatase was considered as a sensing rigidity. And then they proposed this kind of concept. In case of 2 micrometer pillar, the cell are majorly attached on the edge, and then, but in case of 0.5, they are making the focal complex center, and then they can bend it close. But in here, they only can make a push force. So from here, we can say this is the reason why we have to use 0.5 micrometer pillar. And then 0.5 means this 0.5 micrometer, and the gap between the pillar is 1 micrometer. And then when you can see detail using 0.5 micrometer, and then you can make this kind of small gap. So this is during the P2 phase, which shows slower contractile spreading. What's the meaning of the contractile? Contractile means the meaning of the push and pull together. Okay? So which means they behave rhythmically, and then they try to feel the material stiffness. So let's say you can see this kind of some slit, like this is some edge of the cell, like cell membrane, like this area, and then they start to spread, and then this not linear feature, they stop, and then a little bit increase, and then stop, a little bit increase, stop. So this is time is around 20 or 30 seconds. So when you look at this on the PDMS flat, using 0.5 pillar, the time of the event about this gap is 30, around 30 or 25. This is very similar between flat or PDMS pillar. But when you look at the 2 micrometer, they are very different. So this is a cell doesn't have any eye, so they need only hands, which is called integrin. And then through the integrin and then an actin unit, they fill the substrate, and then the time to fill the substrate is 30 seconds. Every 30 seconds, they start to sense, and then they feel, oh, it's okay, and then they spread. Sense, spread. So very dynamically, cell can sense. So also, when you coat certain protein or material nanoparticle on the TCP, and then when you observe this kind of pattern differently, Let's say your nanoparticle or your nanotopology, your stiffness can give more, less shortened time of this sensing, and then also you can report this. This is called chemograph images. Chemograph means time and then area can be visualized together. Chemograph. So from these images, they are using 0.5 micrometer, and then previously they mentioned 0.5 micrometer, they can give push and pull force together. Now they are using stiffness around this one. Maybe this is around 5 kilopascal, something like. And the ultra stiff means 100 kilopascal or 10,000 kilopascal, 1 mega kilopascal, let's say. Well, as you can see, this is the edge of the cell. The cell spread to this direction. Interestingly, when they look at the vector of the pillar, so this red one is, the direction is center, the nucleus, and green one is opposite to the edge, are only observed to this edge area. And then this pull and push, the gap is around 2 micrometer. Okay? But in the center of the nucleus and edge, the cell did not sense. Only from the edge, they sense. And nucleus, somehow, they sense, but the direction is not as comparable to this. This somehow very random. Okay? In here, you can see little push and pull. Push and pull. You can see this kind of certain unit. But here, very not homogeneously, you can observe. But in case of ultra stiff, this kind of tendency is not observed. Somehow, on the edge, the cell tries to sense something, but the rear diffraction value is lower because of the high stiffness. It's not easy to bend. They need more power. Because of that, this sensing is somehow different from here. So the rear absolute value of the diameter change, I mean diffraction change using ultra stiff from the edge of the cell, they are very low and not harmonized. But in case of this low stiffness, inward means to the nucleus, outward means to the spreading direction. You can see clearly within 2 micrometer, they push and pull. And then from 2 to 4 micrometer, they push. And the pulling diameter is around 50 nanometer. Push is around 30 nanometer. Okay, so total 80 nanometer using this 0.5 micrometer pillar, they deflect. Okay, and then when they use other little higher stiffness than this, and also you can observe this kind of pull and push unit as a unit. So we can say that this is some, we can call contraction unit, the unit of the stiffness sensing. But in case of high or ultra low stiffness, there is no contraction unit, only inward for here. So this is some contra means ultra stiff, and then this is like intermediate stiffness. This kind of inward or outer value or maximum force diffraction and the direction is quite highly observed in this flexible pillar, but when they are not flexed because of high stiffness, the cell cannot sense easily. In here, we cannot say which one is more. Here we can say which one is a more proper phenomenon to the cell. Maybe when the cell, like normal fibroblast or mesenchymal cell, they are attached on your tissue. The cell can sense and then change their ECM easily, right? Not easily, I'm not sure. So maybe this kind of blue is a more proper manner. But in case of red, you can observe using artificial tissue culture plate. Okay? So also we can say that why the cells can easily age on artificial culture plate, because the cells are continuously losing their affinity to sense the mechanical property. They cannot make them power to sense the rigidity. And also, when your cells are cultured a very low stiffness area also, only this pulling force are observed. But maybe this also can be observed in real nature. So maybe only pushing and then push and pull as a unit, but not unit is not proper manner. So here, they're introduced contractile unit. So let's say this is the adhesion first, and then they want to go further, spread, and then they need this pull and push as a unit. So this push and pull, you can imagine 2 to 4 micrometer, okay? In here, they mention 2 micrometer from this and this. Using 2 micrometer edge area, they are making this kind of focal adhesion complex, and then they are linked together using alpha actinin and the actin filament and myosin II together, and then they start to fill, and then they are making very high stress fiber. And here, so this is some normal actin, and then the green one is TPM 2.1. This is a tropomyosin, and then myosin 2A can be attached on this actin to change the actin filament for filling the stiffness. But when your cell, like cancer cell or any kind of malfunction cell, they have TPM 3.1, which is highly expressed in cancerous cell, they somehow behave differently. So when you look at the current biology paper, they mention depending on the type of tropomyosin, tropomyosin consists of 0.6, 2.1, 3.1, 4.1, the cell can sense differently behave. So cell rigidity sensing complex is a 2 to 3 micrometer size modular machine that form at the cell periphery during early contact with matrix, maybe for formation of stress fiber or other later cytoskeletal structure. So from which time point? During P2 phase, right? And after 5 minutes later of attachment. And then they are making this kind of sensing complex on the edge cell periphery area, 2 to 3 micrometer size. Okay, so we can call it sarcomere-like contractile unit called CU. Sarcomere-like contractile unit were originally observed in muscle cell, but they find out not only muscle cell but also other kind of cell have this kind of sarcomere-like contractile unit consisting of myosin 2A, as you know, the motor of the actin filament movement, actin filament, and tropomyosin 2.1, and alpha actinin 4, and other cytoskeleton protein. I'm going to show you in detail about the tropomyosin law in our contractile unit. Anyhow, the correct length and duration of contraction are controlled precisely by receptor tyrosine kinase through interaction with cytoskeleton protein. Furthermore, the number of the CU is dependent on EGFR, HER2 activity, as well as on substrate rigidity. So the number of the contraction unit is highly linked to the substrate rigidity, as well as this kind of cancerogenic behave. So on rigid surface, CU stimulate the formation of mature adhesion often leading to growth. This is true. More rigid surface, more CU, and then they can more spread behave. However, on soft substrate, contractions are very short-lived, with rapidly disassembled of adhesion, leading to cell death by anorchis. So on the soft substrate, the CUs not well formed because their contraction units are very short-lived. And then cell fill, from the attachment favor of cell, they want to attach, but the substrate ECM is too soft, they feel like, oh, it's not good place to attach. And then maybe they are in the blood, they feel like, okay, and then I'm in the wrong position. Maybe I have to be suicide. Suicide is anorchis. So the failure of the cancer cell to activate this kind of suicide pathway on salt matrix prompts us, which means the cancer cell, they never die, even on the soft substrate. But the normal cell, they have to die. They are self-reprogrammed to die on soft substrate. So this kind of failure from the cancer cell, self-suicidal, prompts us to postulate that the absence of rigid sensing using CUs in cancer cell enables anchorage independent growth. So maybe the cancer cell, they don't have this kind of rigid sensing. If they have rigid sensing using CU, they sense the soft, and then, oh, this is not enough to stiff, to attach, and then I'm going to die. They have to determine their cell fate. But somehow, the cancer cell, they gone. They are absent about this rigid sensing. And then, from my point of view, they always feel this is good. This is rigidity, enough rigidity to be alive. So, they continuously grow, even on soft substrate. And then you can imagine when you look at the carcinoma, like oral cancer cell or epidermal cell, skin cancer cell, their original origin is from the epidermal keratinocyte, right? Keratinocyte. And then keratinocyte outermost layer, and then between keratinocyte epithelial and connective tissue, they have basal membrane. Basal membrane is anatomical structure to distinguish the epithelial layer and soft tissue. Soft tissue means connective tissue, consists of fibroblast. And in normal epithelial cell, they never penetrate this basal membrane. But when the epithelial cell, they are continuously exposed to chemical or mechanical force, or they are mutated by epigenetically or genetically, somehow their phenotype is changed, and then they can penetrate this basal membrane between the connective tissue epithelial cell. And then they can penetrate connective tissue. And when you imagine epithelial cell compared to epithelial layer and connective tissue layer, which one has more stiff? Maybe epithelial cell, right? When your skin are damaged, your skin is more stiff compared to the inner side of your skin, right? Using connective tissue. So, and then when you imagine this cancer cell penetrate further to the blood vessel, okay? They finally penetrate the endothelial cell, and then they can go to blood vessel for metastasis. And then they flow from the bloodstream, and then they can go brain, and they can go other tissue, from the aorta to foot, or your breast to brain. So when you imagine this, the original epithelial cell, when they go to the soft, like adipose tissue, or brain, or other like more soft tissue, they have to be survived. And then people previously think that how they can survive in the soft matrix is somehow they are mutation of P53 or their absence of some self, how can I say, they continuously grow from the mutation of some cell cycle checkpoint or certain kind of mutation related to self growth, grow. But in another concept, here they mentioned that, okay, this is true. Cell growth or stopping or start the growth can be damaged by epigenetically or genetically. But in another point of view, when the cell diminishes the radiative sensing, and then they can grow in any kind of soft or stiff matrix. This is another kind of view compared to previous concept. So this is very interesting point. So and then when you can enlarge this kind of point to other regenerative phenotype, for example, you want to study about the continuous inflammation stage like diabetic wound healing or osteoarthritis or liver failure, alcoholic liver failure, any kind of disease, not immediate disease, but they are continuously systemically damaged, and then somehow the cell are continuously damaged, maybe they can lose the radiative sensing behavior from the inflammatory cell or residual cell like osteoblast, muscle cell, or chondrocyte cell. And then this kind of absence of radiative sensing can cause the disease phenotype. So that is why even though you put your material or your stem cell a lot on the damaged tissue, it's not easy to regenerate because the residual tissue are always damaged in terms of mechanical sensing behavior. So this is another concept, how you approach to regenerate your tissue of interest. So this is some normal feature of the tropomyosin, and this actin filament monomer, they are filamented. And then troponin is, this purple is actin monomer, and then tropomyosin is blue. The troponin, they link, they, how can I say, change the tropomyosin behavior. So when the calcium is attached on the troponin, what happened? This is the normal structure. They shield this troponin complex, tropomyosin, troponin complex, they shield the myosin 2A attaching site. Okay, but when the calcium is bound to the troponin, and then this tropomyosin, troponin structure are changed, and then this kind of myosin binding site is exposed. And then myosin 2A, they are attaching on this site, and then they can push and pull to make the force. This is the normal behavior of the troponin, tropomyosin, and actin and calcium behavior. And then you can imagine, when your cultured cell, like Hubeck cell is especially very sensitive to calcium, because Hubeck cell, they can consist of endothelial cell, right? They are one of the endothelial cell line. Endothelial cell, they always need tight junction, and then they have to resist very powerful blood pressure, and then they need more contractile unit. And then when you wash the Hubeck cell using PBS without any calcium, and then this kind of ectomyosin 2 and myosin 2A exposed site are diminished, they are shielded. And then Hubeck cell are easily detached from the TCP. So you can observe very easily when you add the PBS on the Hubeck cell culture plate, you can dramatic change of the Hubeck cell line. So after 5 minutes, they are totally detached. So depending on cell types, this kind of calcium effect you can observe very dramatically. So mutation and abnormal expression of various cytoskeleton and osseous protein have been reported in many cancer cells. Especially, MAGEN2A identified as a tumor suppressor in multiple carcinoma. Why? In terms of the radiative sensing concept, tumor cells, they are losing MAGEN2A. So the normal function of the MAGEN2A is diminished, which means the cancer cell, they continuously make the force to grow or to go other tissue. And the expression level of the tropomyosin 2.1 is highly suppressed, lower in cancer cell. TPM 2.1 is a very normal feature. You can see, what is the meaning of normal feature? They are solely dynamics, and then they can on and off slowly. But in case of TPM 3.1, which was highly observed in cancer cell, they always rapid dynamics, so activation of myosin 2 is highly unregulated. They always activate the myosin 2A. So TPM 3 is commonly overexpressed in primary tumor and tumor cell line. However, nobody study about what is the real meaning of TPM 2.1 and TPM 3.1 in terms of the mechanical sensing from the cell, cancer cell. So this paper in Nature Material, they are focusing on the mechanical sensing unit and the relationship between TPM 2.1 and 3.1. So when you can imagine, okay, cancer cell have a lot of TPM 3.1. And then when you decrease or knock down the TPM 3.1, the cancer cell, they can behave normally, right? And in other way, normal cell TPM 2.1 is changed to TPM 3.1, normal cell can behave like tumor cell. And this kind of concept is revealed in this coming paper. So as a conclusion of this paper, you can say that this left one and right one is a different paper. Well, left one is, this is, I can show you that this is a contraction unit to sense the residue of ECM. And then when you knock down the alpha actinin, which can link the focal and complex and actin filament and myosin 2A as another linker, and then the cell cannot sense the ECM, and then they cannot spread enough. In this paper, through the tropomyosin, myosin, and focal adhesion, any kind of complex, when this is normal, this is a cancerous cell, the normal cell using the TPM tropomyosin 2.1, and then they can dynamically, slowly, myosin 2A attach and detach, and then after radiative sensing from this kind of sensing unit on the soft, they can be dead. And then, because TPM 2.1 and myosin 2A is diminished on the soft substrate. In hard, this is on, myosin 2A and TPM 2.1 on, and then they can survive through the radiative sensing. But your cancer cell, they are repressed to TPM 3.1, and then they continuously introduce the cell contractility. So regardless and soft and hard, they cannot sense the radiative sensing, which means they cannot distinguish soft and stiff because of malfunction of the sensor. So in either way, they can survive. So as a last feature, I'm going to show you very simple. Okay, this is some published in Nature Material 2012 by the Michael Pischitt. Michael Pischitt is a very big guy of this mechanobiology field, and he is a founder of the Mechanobiology Center and Institute in Singapore National University. Now he is an emeritus professor in Chicago, previously Columbia, before Duke University. So anyhow, this big grandpa showed us that this is some normal cell from 10 to 20 minutes. So you can imagine 10 to 20 minutes means during the P2 phase, right? P2 phase, when cell using contractly when they spread. And then in P2 phase, on the edge, they have this kind of unit, blue and red. They're depicted like this. And then you know this diffraction of the pillar in to the nucleus, to the edge. And then unpaired and paired means unpaired like this kind of red only. Paired means blue and red together. So they are depicted, and the average of unpaired pair is depicted in the old pillar. So from the normal cell up to upper paired, you can see 30% from the human fetal fibroblast. But when you look at the same cell line, cell type, but transformed cell, this is another kind of transform they just mentioned as one of the cancer cell. In under context of this transformed cell is that all kind of cancer cell, we can call it transformed cell. Transform means some mutation or something change. But we cannot say all transformed cell is cancer cell. Okay? Somehow, the normal cell, they are a little bit transformed, and they can behave a little differently, but not much, the cancer cell. So this is some kind of, so that is why they, and then, so they can mention this kind of cancer cell as a transformed cell. And then when you look at this, the vector, the change of direction of the pillar, you cannot see any kind of blue, which means only push to the nuclear site of observed, to the center. That is why all pillar and unpaired is same. And then you cannot see any paired pillar. So which means transformed cells, somehow they are damaged or mutation in any way, they lose the sense to lose the rigidity using contracture unit. Contrast unit means this blue and red parallel unit. So cell, normal cell, they have this kind of sensing pattern that they can sense, but the cancer cell, they cannot sense. And then even when you look at this diffraction change of the pillar up to 100, or 100 or 70 nanometer, right? But in normal cell, their value is 70 or 60. So the power to push to the nuclear site is quite higher in transformed cell, like cancer cell. And here, when you look at the cell feature, this is some per area, how much of the contrast unit are visualized. In normal cell, you can see 40 unit contrast unit paired, but other kind of all kind of cancer cell from the breast cancer, oral cancer, or epidermal cancer, any kind of cancer, they are gone. They don't have any contrast unit, regardless of rigid and soft substrate. Rigid, they have more contrast unit, and soft, less contrast unit, but cancer cell, they don't have any contrast unit. And then when you look at their cell spreading behave on rigid, 2 megapascal, soft, 5 kilopascal, 5, round, rigid, they spread it. But in case of other five kind of cell, cell behave similarly. Okay? They never feel the rigidity. So nowadays, we are culturing the cancer cell on the soft and rigid. But somehow, or a cancer cell, or depending on cancer cell type, the cell can, when cell lose the rigidity sensing unit, they cannot show different cell behave on different stiffness. Okay? And then this is very interesting. When you culture your cell on the agar plate, I have to look at in detail, agar plate is coated or fibronectin or not. When you culture the agar plate, normal cell, all cells are dead. But the cancer cell, somehow they are making spheroid or in any other way, they can survive. This is the quantification of this, how the cells survive. So you can simply evaluate your cancer cell of your hand, whether they have sensing unit or not. So for example, you have oral cancer cell, like two or three type, you culture the cancer cell in agar plate, same as this platform. And then they are growing, and then, oh, my cancer cell are losing their contraction unit. And then, even though I culture this cancer cell on different substrate, they never show different PA in terms of cell spreading and cell aspect area ratio, okay? So this is another aspect. And then, when they look at their kinase related to the focal and contraction unit, like EGFR, HER2, RR2, MYCIN2A, TPM2.1, and TPM3, and this is some housekeeping, normal cell, they have all kind of protein related to contraction unit. But in case of cancer cell, at least one thing is gone. In LLC, this gone, and then TPM2.1 is very lowly expressed, but TPM3 is highly expressed in cancer cell compared to normal. So from the next images, they always do like one by one. Okay, this one of the transformed cell, cancer cell, they don't have contraction unit. But we from the external point, when we highly expressed myosin-2A, they recover the contraction unit, and then their cell can finally sense the rigid on this on myosin-2A overexpressed this cancer cell. So they spread more and less spread, but in normal, in original condition of the transformed cell, the cell cannot sense the rigidity, and then cell behaves similarly. So all kind of other research, other figure is related to this. So from this paper, we can, one take home message from this thing is that you can think about how the cell sense the rigidity, and then depending on the cancer cell and normal cell, and normal cell and damaged cell from the original tissue, cells can lose the sensing PA. And then this losing the sensing PA can be easily determined by this agar plate seeding. And then maybe after 7 days, you can observe how the cell grow or not. Okay, any question? And then you can also think about, let's say your normal cell, they have to die, or your damaged cell from the tissue, they are somehow losing the sensing and they are growing. And then we have to find a way how the material and how we can change the ECM to make them die. Because the malfunction cell should be dead for your cell body, your whole cell body, whole body structure. But this malfunction cell, they continuously live, and then they can damage your tissue. So that is why the cell have self-reprogrammed cell death programming, like apoptosis, anorexia, and then they should be engulfed by the immune cell when they are damaged. But somehow they are not cleared out, and then only way is for having intervention like medical surgery or physical extract the damaged tissue. Okay, thank you.